What's up, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls? Welcome to Starladder Season 6. My name is Epi, and we have Na'Vi playing versus Power Rangers right now. Power Rangers just went down versus Z-Rage, but hey, if it doesn't work against Z-Rage, then Na'Vi is a team that you can just walk over very easily. So let's watch how that undertaking unfolds for Power Rangers. Perhaps they have some pocket strat, maybe Na'Vi not, you know, on their best today. Maybe they were partying yesterday or something, but we'll see how it all plays out. But all jokes aside, welcome in Power Rangers to the competition. Best of luck versus Na'Vi. It's going to be amazing training. That's at least the least that you're going to get out of it. And I trust in you guys. I've seen you guys perform tremendously before, and I think that you have what it takes to beat teams like this, although I think perhaps the polls would not agree. But I'm always for the underdog, so let's see how this goes. I'm joined by Lawai today. He's from Druids. How are you doing, my man?
Yeah, I'm doing great. We have a great match, and I'm also hoping Power Rangers can make something. It would be really fun to see. And yeah, but Na'Vi has full squad, no stand-ins, as people didn't want him to. But so does Power Rangers. And what's up with this Luna guy? He disconnects every time I see him. He always disconnects in the beginning of the game.
Yeah, anyway, I don't know, maybe his computer's weird.
Ban of CK. That's interesting.
Maybe that's first pick Wisp.
Sorry, I'm speechless. Why would you ban CK if you're planning to pick up Wisp? CK is not a counter to Wisp. Maybe they don't want Na'Vi to pick him because they think CK is a now overpowered hero. Okay, this is gonna be interesting. This will be an interesting draft.
At least, man, it's first pick the Wisp. The ban on CK doesn't make a whole lot of sense at this stage. Maybe it's to throw off Puppy. He's right now maybe holding his tummy and laughing or something, so he's gonna have a rough time and he misclicks and picks Kunkka. Lodron and Kunkka, my goodness, those are very, very tanky heroes. If Kunkka, I'm trying to see this from the perspective of the Wisp ganking right now. If Kunkka gets ganked by a Wisp, then Wisp needs to make sure they have something to reveal because he will definitely go for that Shadow Blade build. Lone Druid is pretty tanky and the bear can fight back. Funnik also a tremendous Lone Druid player. And I feel like that's a pretty solid start so far. And Shadow Demon is still in the pool, which is a support that Power Rangers might not want to pick up right now. I mean, Wisp is a pretty weak laner anyway. So I don't know if a Shadow Demon will be the best pick for them right now for a defensive tri-lane. But on the other hand, Na'Vi, they would love to have a Shadow Demon as a third pick, and I think this is the direction that Puppy is thinking with his picks right now.
Kunkka is really seeing a lot of play.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, the Xbox spot worked out quite well.
Super interesting. Oh yeah, of course, it works out a great with Wisp, but yeah, this is the first time I've seen Na'Vi pick a Wisp. But how do you kill a Lone Druid with the Kunkka rum from Ghost Ship on it? I don't know if that's possible, man. Synergize well.
Darkseer is a good start. So we saw the power of the wall in last game. It's getting that copy up, especially with an Aghanim Scepter, is pretty powerful. I mean, getting that Aghs first is an important step. And it's actually Power Rangers really picking up the Shadow Demon. So what are your thoughts? Am I maybe a little bit underestimating Shadow Demon's laning potential?
No, I don't know what to say. Okay, Shadow Demon is a great laner, of course. He has offensive and disruptive abilities, but okay, they go for Visage. But I don't know, what are they looking to get done here? Shadow Demon and Wisp aren't really carries supports that synergize too well. Oh yeah, it's gonna be interesting. Visage, solid carry, they're probably going offensive tri-lane, perhaps with Kunkka. They didn't get the Shadow Demon, so Visage is also a great slow to hit the torrent with because it's, I don't know, it's 80, 70% slow. It, like, the first second, she basically just stands still. So they take him away Puppy Shen, that's to counter the pushing power they would have gotten with Lone Druid and Shen and Kunkka. And I'm really interested to see what Power Rangers are gonna pair up the Wisp with. We have the classic combos, Tiny, Ricky,
PA as of late also picked off.
PA. Yeah. Since CK is taken out, Naix is also a great combo, but Naix is taken out. Yeah, this is interesting. I think you were correct when you were saying Power Rangers need to bring out their pocket strat. Because I feel this is a pocket strat.
I mean, the thing is, Na'Vi, they picked up Lone Druid and Kunkka. Those are very tanky heroes that are capable of doing a lot of stuff in the game in terms of impact. Kunkka, of course, has a big skill set. The cleave helps as well. He has a lot of physical damage to dish out. Lone Druid takes a little while before he hits the game or has impact on the game, but when he has impact, he is one of the strongest heroes in there. And Visage, I think, is a signal from Puppy, or at least I read into that Visage pick, that they really want to fight hard early on. They don't like Wisp a lot. Puppy has said it time and time again that Wisp is a hero that he does not like to play against. And they pick up Visage. So Visage is a great fighter in try versus try situations. So I feel like they want to kind of build up on the fact that Power Rangers are perhaps lacking a bit of power in the tri lane department. Put the Visage, Kunkka, and plus one in there perhaps, or Kunkka solo mid, and they pick the core of the tri lane in the last two picks, and then try to just absolutely wreak havoc on that enemy safe lane and utterly destroy what Power Rangers are trying to do. And if a Wisp doesn't have the farm early on, then he can have the ultimate, he can have that relocate, but by that point in time, Navi's heroes will be so farmed, so stacked, that it really will not make a whole lot of sense. So let's go over to the bans real quick. Puppy does not want to have an Alchemist inside of this game, so they banned that one out. Luna as well, and he is now deciding on that last ban. And Power Rangers, if I remember correctly, they banned out Chen and Enchantress last game as well.
Yeah, they did. That was because of the pushing power. No, wait! Didn't Rage ban them out?
Seconds. Yeah, at least one team banned two of them out.
Yeah, one team did it. Anyway, Luna City does this incredibly well with Darkseid, just because of her glaives. Alchemist kinda does also. Vacuum into Alchemist done. Bam! And they pick out the Tiny, obviously because of the Wisp. Or should we call him Io? And this is the interesting part. What does Power Rangers want to go for? I'm seriously hoping for Ricky.
Ah, so the chat is has done their homework and they let us know as to why they think the CK was banned. So I think one thing that Orgulux... it's a French name. My apologies. I'm not so good with that. Ogolo, I'll just go with that. Ban CK, so Navi won't ban Wisp. So perhaps it was a signal to try and keep Puppy from banning out the Wisp. In that case, it really worked. And ATJJ says, Puppy once said that the Wisp only works with CK. That's why they banned CK. So Navi won't pick Wisp. And they will... And then that's an open end to that story. So he just stops talking. All right. Short attention span then, I guess, but I mean, it worked out. They got the Wisp, but I'm still missing the hero that they want to combo him off with, and they have Darkseer, Shadow Demon, and Cardle picked up. So Cardle, Shadow Demon, like, my goodness, what are we looking at here?
Yeah, this is a Wisp mid.
A Wisp mid?
It has to be. Unless they fail picked. Let's bring up the chat and say if they're... Nope. It's the Cardle, so I'm thinking Wisp mid. It kind of has to be. I don't see how they're laning this otherwise. Maybe Wisp easy lane, and I mean, there could be a Darkseid tri lane with the Cuddle and the Shadow Demon. That's a cool idea. And then Wisp mid or easy lane. We'll see. This is the interesting part. Now 80 seconds to decide, but I think they've already decided which hero they're getting.
I'm hearing some good calls here. Besides the Ricky and the PA, Sven. Says ATJJ.
Sven is also a possibility, of course.
Sven could work. He hits really, really hard. And Nyx Assassin, Spike Carapace will probably be the... Well, I guess there's also the Entang from the Lone Druid. So it makes that pick very, very risky. So I think Sven is a nice idea, I don't think that they should go for that hero. So Nyx Assassin, Visage, Kunkka, and Lone Druid are the heroes from Na'Vi right now. Danny could play Kunkka. And there's the PA pick. So, whoa. It might also be... Well, what could it be? If we look at the lanes here, yeah, it could be a solo mid Wisp, could be a solo mid Shadow Demon even, but throwing the weak tri-laner in Wisp into the middle lane is definitely a good way to get rid of all these problems. Just have a tri-lane consisting of Shadow Demon, Cardle, and PA. So I'm liking the draft of Power Rangers so far. Last pick is Quap, and Dandy picks that one up. So just to make sure that whoever Power Rangers throw into the solo mid role will get utterly annihilated by arguably one of the strongest solo mid players in the world right now.
This is very weird, because last game, the guy who I'm not going to even try to pronounce was playing the Gyro. What was the name?
Cheshire Cat.
Checked off. Jesus Christ. Okay, he was playing the Gyro, I signed the carry. And, well, Moon was playing the Juggernaut, but the Pink was playing mid. But now this is a Shadow Demon mid.
Yeah, there could be a ZXC's the mid player.
He must be Shadow Demon mid, because he's the mid player.
Level 1 smoke happening right now. Navi rotating over toward the bottom lane as well. Dandy playing co-op. We got Havast on Kunkka. Puppy, he'll be playing Nyx Assassin. Kuro on Visage, microing those ultimate birds.
Oh, he's funny. Level 1 Roche. Roche, look.
Oh my god. The pings are going crazy. They're wishing good luck, have fun. They start right clicking. The damage is not quite there, but is Na'Vi thinking that this might be a level 1 Roshan? This is quite something.
This is what you have to do against a team like Na'Vi. Get a level 1 Roshan. No, don't die!
Oh! Oh, they took the aggro off last second. Cheshire Cat gets away. That was powerful. Moon now also tanking there. Oh man. Oh man, those bashes now coming in. Cheshire Cat, you're in trouble, son. Now Wisp, it's his turn to tank. The creeps will be there in 15 seconds. This is a very long level 1 Roshan, and if they fail this, it's definitely gonna hurt. Moon still going at it. Power Rangers trying to make a name of themselves right now. Wisp with the tether going crazy. Moon still tanking. Look at that HP regen though, just by virtue of that self. So he's tanking Roshan quite effectively right now. The creeps are spawning, and Na'Vi! Chavos is going in there! He finds them! He pings them! He goes for the splash, looking for the cleave damage. He didn't even go for the torrent. That's probably not the best skill to go for. Roshan. Roshan goes down. PA picks it up. Na'Vi coming in. The cavalry is here. Puppy has that stun. Hits two heroes. Moon in trouble. Gets focused on Chavos. He does go down. First blood goes to Power Rangers. Chavos is dead. Puppy getting chased. ZXC on the charge. They're all on level 2. They're totally stronger than Na'Vi right now. All their other players are not close enough. ZXC gets stunned by Puppy. He gets the kill before he himself goes down. 2-1 so far. And further east, we have Kuroki on the runaway from Moon as well as Khan. And I think that he will also drop 3 heroes dead. A level 1 Roshan, and they only lose 1 hero. To be chosen for
death. Yeah, the Lost Ages. That's a big pop. The Lost Ages.
Yeah, I think that's okay, man. They're all on level 2 right now. They have a big experience advantage. They lost Aegis. That's totally fine. But they got 3 kills in return, man. That's quite a bit.
Yeah, that was really fun. Oh, poor Hivos. He got stuck between the two illusions of Shadow Demon. Otherwise, he had first blood one guest.
You serious? He got stuck?
Yeah, he got stuck at the Roche Pit. They did it right against their mountain wall or whatever you want to call it. And he got stuck. Otherwise, he could have cleaved on two dogs. Yeah. Okay, that was sick. That got me really excited. And it's a Wisp mid. I told you, man. Wisp mid.
Wisp mid, played by Kant, has the bottle ready versus Dendi. And Dendi is gonna, yeah, he puts 2 points into Shadow Strike. He is intent on destroying Wisp in the solo middle lane. And Na'Vi, not made a fool of, but that would be too unkind of a phrasing. But you know what I'm trying to say. Power Rangers, they had a pretty cheeky strat, and it worked out brilliantly for them. And Na'Vi, inherently, at a little bit of a disadvantage. That extra experience definitely helps out Wisp in his capability of standing versus Dendi. The bottle's already ready, but in the long run, Dendi is probably going to seize control of this middle lane. And look at that. Every time he sees Wisp, he goes in aggressively and tries to zone him out.
Yeah. How's top lane? Okay, so Phonic, is he getting anything done? Yeah, he's pulling. No, he's not pulling. Ah, he got one creep, man. No, he turned. How's Phonic? He's gonna rotate into jungle.
Down here, we got Cheshire Cat in trouble. Goes for the Surge away. But no mana on Nyx Assassin for that stun. The mana burn has already been used. And Havas on bottom lane, just safely farming away. 10-3 last hits on the guy. Fought by Dendi. 10-10 on him, so he's, as always, performing brilliantly in the middle lane. Moon on top, safe laning also on 10. Last hits and one kill as well. So far, I must say, this is the kind of thing, as you said during the Roshan attempt, this is what Power Rangers need to do against a team like Na'Vi, because the odds are heavily against them, as Nudie also pointed out in the stat overlay, that over 98% actually bet on Na'Vi over on JoinDota.com, so that's really quite a bit.
Yeah, look at the net worth. Okay, they're coming up now, Kunkka and independent, but for a while, I mean, the supports I had, they're really ahead.
So last time this team met was in the previous season of Starladder in Radiant's number 5, and Power Rangers won, so again, big thank you to Nudie. And
they beat Na'Vi? That's impressive.
Yeah, the Power Rangers, man. You don't beat the Power Rangers.
Puppy rotating top to get that delicious XP. He's level 4 already. That's really good by him. He's the same level as their...
Oh man, Wisp drops in the middle lane. My apologies.
Oh, no, that's bad. Okay, but Puppy has a great level because he got a solo kill earlier in the rush attempt. Phonic is doing great. What is Cuddle going for? Oh, he's going for... he has a headdress. Oh, he's going for a quick mecha, of course.
Moon, 16 last hits, phase boots are up, Funny can't do a whole lot, and Dendi, even though he was at a disadvantage in terms of experience, he just denied the hell out of his enemy. And with that kill in mid, he's a whole level ahead of Wisp. Even more than that. Wisp isn't even level 5 yet, and Dendi's almost level 7. So Dendi on co-op, he's going to be a beast to deal with, I think, once he rotates. Puppy on top lane getting slowed down. There's the blink into a disruption. He does have a level 1 spike carapace, so he's holding on to that until the very end, and now it's gone. Will he survive? I doubt it! There's that Illuminate, but PA is still the one that that's getting the kill, so that's definitely a great situation for Power Rangers. They're just hanging out underneath the T1 tower for the creep wave to come in and tank. And then they will apply some pressure. Ping goes off from Puppy, so Power Rangers are fighting hard. Bottom lane in the meantime, Kuroki and Hofoss teaming up, applying pressure on the tier 1 on bottom themselves as Kant on EO is rotating toward bottom and leaving Dendi by himself. So this guy is still farming like crazy. Puppy shows up, goes for the mana burn on PA, and Power Rangers get this tower down to 500 and then some
bottom
HP.
Lane.
Bottom lane. A lot of stuff going on. Wisp is here. Kuroki getting focused. The right click's coming in. One more right click from Kant. Is it going to be in there for the damage? He turns around, switches the target. Now they're going on to Hofoss. Where's the tether? It is going to be ready soon. They get the tether stun out. The spirit's coming up. Hofoss might be in trouble. Kant needs to micro those. Oh man, there might be a double kill. Might be two heroes going down if they manage to micro their orbs correctly. Kuroki actually goes down. Very low life on Wisp. He's actually surviving. There's a torrent. Torrent gets the kill from Hofoss. Now Cheshire Cat in trouble. Funny Cat has rotated. He's here. The bear's a little bit too slow though. Hofoss still trying to do some damage, but Darkseer will not be killed. What a torrent by Hofoss, at least getting one kill.
Yeah. Insane Hofoss torrent. Oh wait, Hofoss might be in trouble. Look at it.
Hofoss? Oi, 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 oi. Look at that. Darkseer turns around and he's like, damn it! Torrent.
Okay, so. But Puppy is almost level 6.
Oh, Dendi, there's that rotation. Just melts Charity instantly. Now Moon needs to blink strike himself away. Luna is here. No, now he has the Illuminate. He needs to turn on and go for that if the chase keeps on going on. But Moon gets away safely, and there's that rotation that a co-op is known for. As soon as she gets those levels, she leaves her mid lane and has impact on the sides.
Yeah, yes. She has such a high burst damage. That's level 6 for... Okay, almost. Oh, Dendi's in trouble.
Dendi is in trouble. My goodness. Wisp.
That was sick. He tethered his own creep, so Dendi got stunned, and then they killed him with the balls. The spirits.
It thought creep.
Okay, someone in the chat.
Command
I,
great.
I do want a translation. Wisp TPing bottom. Getting in courier. Radiant's courier.
This Wisp is doing so much work. Hofoss in trouble as well. This team fight is going crazy everywhere. Power Rangers, what are you doing? You are just pretending you are not able to beat Na'Vi by, you know, you said, okay, we're gonna lose the game against Z-Rage, but against Na'Vi, we're gonna do our very best, and you guys are performing quite strong so far, especially this Wisp, this Solomon Wisp. He got destroyed on lane, and now again, Dendi taking some punishment, but Dendi will not try to be messed with right now. He is mad, he's angry, he wants to get that kill, and Wisp might have overextended, but Dendi controlled aggression, turns back out around, he does not want to risk dying, but Wisp needs to be pretty careful right now. Tether gets used one more time, Dendi turns around, goes in, the scream, did it hit? I'm not even sure. In the meantime, Nyxstaz gets killed on PA, Dendi throws out his slow, and Power Rangers can't, this guy is destroying Dendi right now, he killed him twice, that doesn't happen very often to the guy from Ukraine.
Come on, Dendi, flame him. Flame the Wisp.
Oh man, this is your once in a lifetime chance to go off chat and flame Dendi. Oh man.
Okay. So yeah. Nyx used his early one that tank killed PA. That's not good. PA is going for drums. Kunkka is going for probably drums as well. He has the bracer pick up. He steals Dendi's rune. How's our Darkseer looking? Yes, Tranquils, okay. So all in all, it's going good for Power Rangers right now.
It really is. I mean, look at the gold. It's 2.5k in favor of Power Rangers. The experience, about 1.3. And if we look at the items, let's see how this... Oh man, disruption middle lane into a Wisp ultimate. Dendi! There's a stun from Puppy. The team captain is here to help him out. And my goodness, this ultimate so strong. Shadow Demon almost dropping, gets surged away. And Wisp will take him back further up on the... top rune spot, a good torrent hits by Hofoss on Darkseer, he's in trouble. The boat coming in. Cheshire Cat needs to rotate further to the left, but Queen of Pain is there with the scream, gets the last hit. But let's be honest, Dendi doesn't care about that, he wants to kill Wisp.
Yeah. His only target is Wisp. He's been dishonored by this Wisp, as the Chinese guys and Japanese guys would say. How's Fennec looking? Oh, he's soloing bottom lane.
Yeah, but he only has 29 last hits, so he's really had a rough start. He's looking for his hand of Midas by the looks of it right now.
I think he's trying to adapt to the new change. Realizing that he can't go for Armlet after the change, so he has to go back to the Midas and Maelstrom build. The Midas for the instant attack speed, not only for the gold, but attack speed as well. And just as I say that, he picks up a helm of an Iron Will. Thanks, man. Okay, so he's not adapting to the new change.
0, 2, and 3 on Visage in the meantime. Moon has Drums of Endurance completed, 2-1-1, 9 minutes into the game, 39 last hits. It's not a whole lot, so Power Rangers definitely not that far ahead that they have big control of the game. They still need to do more, and Kuroki being very, very careful on top. The ward gets spotted. Kuroki does ping it out, and any follow-up on top, Power Rangers looking to make something happen on this top tier 1, but Navi is rotating. They do want to fight. Let's have a TP check. Khovost has it, but half a minute he cannot TP, and Fnatic does not have a TP scroll, so it's going to be 5 versus 3 if Power Rangers commit to this push, and I think they should. If they knew what we know right now, I think they would definitely commit to this push, but they're not.
Alright, so Wisp TP on Fnatic bottom.
Fnatic! Wisp coming in! Shadowdemon here as well, there's the ultimate, and Fnatic is not as tank as he would like to be right now. The ulti from Shadowdemon is going to melt him, explodes. A very good ultimate by Wisp. And now
and
they can push.
Back they go, and that's tier 1 tower. I mean, this is really awesome. Go Power Rangers!
Go Power Rangers! Holy crap, that's really, really good. Moon still has those drums. Kuroki microing his minions in here, the familiars, to go for a little bit of a stunnage, but the tier 1 tower still doing some damage. Puppy is here, Wisp out of position! Down he goes, Phantom Assassin gets a kill on Visage in return though, they're diving like crazy. No, Moon is on the run out, gets X though, he's getting chased. Puppy waiting for the stun cooldown, he does have the manager's head and he won't have it for a very long time. Juke by Moon! Juke by Moon! He's still running! The drum charge, the blink strike, Dendi in trouble, Dendi in trouble, is there gonna be a crit? He blinks away, Moon gets ultied! Dendi had enough of his shenanigans and just turns around and wipes him.
Oh, too bad, I really wanted a crit there.
Everybody wanted a crit there, man. Everybody loves the underdogs. Fnatic though, wow, that was cool. He was anticipating a deny attempt here by the looks of it, or he was just slow and hit the S button by mistake, but he gets a last hit, mid tier 1 drops, and Navi coming back into this game here by the looks of it. Cheshire Cat on bottom, pressuring the tier 1 tower, the gold graph coming back up, the TP on toward the bottom lane. It is going to be Kuroki, who's sitting at level 7. 1 point in Grave Chill as well as Gravekeeper's Cloak, and of course max out Soul Assumption. But Power Rangers, they're heading into the mid game slowly but surely, and they don't have an answer just yet for all the mid game power on Navi's side. PA, she isn't that powerful just yet. 3-2-1, only 50 last hits so far. She needs more. She needs that BKB. She needs to be able to attack consistently. And even so, Fnatic, with his bear, will be able to root him and entangle him and hinder the movements of PA. And I definitely don't think that Navi are out of this game by any stretch of the imagination. Puppy, bottom lane, Cheshire Cat in trouble. There's that mana burn doing so much damage. Spike Carapace is there. Down goes Darkseer, and now I think it's Na'Vi taking Power Rangers very seriously.
Yeah, they have stopped fooling around, which you obviously could saw they're doing mid and middle. Get middle, Wisp.
Wisp in mid. Na'Vi, Khovost getting attacking.
Tether stop.
Yeah, and there's
he's
a tether stop. Ultimate. He's going to be fine, but he will be back in a bit. Is he going to have a surprise with him, though? Where's Wisp? In base. Nobody's there. He's like, buddies, come on, TP back to base so I can take you with me.
Okay, he's dying.
Oh, tether. Wow, that timing with the torrent, this stun from Puppy, Na'Vi, a lot of experience playing against that Wisp. Down he goes, and now even Charity might be in trouble. Dendi, is he going to blink after him? That's a big question. The familiar is giving him vision, but they don't want to overextend trying to chase a Shadow Demon there, but they get the kill on Wisp. He was trying to tether away. That was a good movement by his teammate as well, but in the end, Na'Vi, too quick, too smart. Luna fighting against familiars here and getting pretty... Yeah, a lot of damage in. Further up, we got Dendi eating a vacuum, but he's still up, sitting at 570 if he isn't tread switching. And now it's 10-10, 30 minutes into the game, and Na'Vi kind of slowed down the pace of the game and even managed to get the XP graph working in their favor. The gold graph now as well, ever so slightly, as the armlet is completed on Fnatic.
Yeah, and we have the armlet. Wait, is this a bug just for me? He has the armlet toggled on himself, and he's gaining HP, not losing it.
I can see that too.
What? Oh, okay. He activated it on the spirit brand and transferred it, which means the HP loss doesn't exist, but he's not gaining the thingies either. The on bonuses. He's not gaining the 31 damage and such.
But wow, that was very confusing. In the meantime, Kant trying to get himself away. He's still alive, but there's a big soul sound from Kuroki. Going to seal that deal on his life. ZXC being attacked by Kuroki. Will he be able to get that kill? Second soul sound almost gets a kill on Charity, but not quite enough. Moon, in the meantime, will get a kill in return on Kuroki. Puppy has also dropped. And I was very confused about this armlet thing you were talking about. Holy crap. It looked very, very odd indeed.
Yeah. I don't know why he did that. I'm sorry, but I don't know. But he activated it on the bear and then transferred it over. Now he has to activate it on the bear. How's our Darkseer looking? He's going for...
So Voss, he's very intent on this kill. Oh man, that boat torrent combination! He just really wants that kill. Khovost solo killing that poor Cartless puppy looking for the retreating moon on PA. He's gonna find him at this creep spot too. That's just experienced movement by Puppy. Gonna find him, it's gonna be follow up. There's a attack, backstab, bonus damage, mana burn, and stun. And now Puppy will just have to try and go for the body block. As Dendi is here, the cavalry has arrived, the slow is there. The right click is coming through, the drums will not help. Down he goes, the tether was there momentarily, but it's really not enough. Now Shadow Demon gets caught out as well. ZXC in big trouble, can't. On Wisp, doing a bunch of damage, but now himself also in trouble. Does he have anything to tether to? That's a big question. Dendi, is he going to keep on chasing? He's pretty mad right now, so perhaps he does want to. He really... What's he doing? Okay.
Yeah. They're going... I think both teams has a lot of fun here.
X marks the spot. Wisp in trouble. Dendi, he's looking for the right angle to ultimate. Instead, he just goes in between two heroes and goes for a scream of pain. Yo! Tries to ulti out, it was so close, but Khovost still gets the kill, and Keep of Light also drops. Now Cheshire Cat is here, Funnik has arrived on the scene, Puppy's here as well, gets out the stun with the Spike Carapace, but in the end, it's not quite enough. Now the bear's going in, looking for that lucky entangle. Is he going to find it? Dendi also there. Oh my goodness, one hit entangle on the Darkseer. Defensive Disruption, the Torrent going to miss. ZXC is here, but still Cheshire Cat in trouble. Dendi can't go for the finish, but they might have to deny their teammate here. They might have to deny him.
He has one stick shard. He's surviving.
He's good. The bear just dropped. That's 100 gold to bounty, but soon to be 300.
Thanks, Stats Guy. Apparently, it's the same mid player.
Uh-huh.
Cat played on some other name. So, yeah, that's that. Thanks. I heard someone saying in chat that Navis, if they're playing from China. No, they're not. They're going at end of June, I think, after Starladder. Do you know?
No, I don't. I'm sorry. Okay. Luna getting tethered, getting slowed by Dendi. Wisp is here. He's hasting away.
This Wisp is extremely talented.
Yeah.
I just have to say that he's extremely good with Wisp. Okay, PA is going for the Desolator, so she's going to do a lot of damage. But how is... Oh, Dendi is forced to go straight into PKB, actually. He has it now. But that's some respect for Power Rangers.
Absolutely.
Kuroki hasn't been in fights. He has been farming in quite a while. He's going for... He has to get a medallion now. But how is the big guy seeing? Okay, he is working on his shadow blade.
So Funnik is really enjoying this visual bug.
Yeah.
It's just a visual thing.
I think he's trying to confuse us.
Yeah, it really worked out. In the middle lane, in the meantime, we have PA going aggressive. But Puppy... No, Puppy was just invis, and Moon wasn't aware that Puppy was there. Defensive Disruption going to keep him alive for now. That was actually pretty good by Shadow Demon. Will Moon be fine? Blinks away, and is safe, and goes for the freaking drum charge, and gets away. What a play by ZXC, completely making that worthwhile. Kant, though, might have overextended here. That Soul Sum's going to come in. He's going to ulti out, and we'll be back in just a bit, but Khovost will also be there. Last time, he managed to do a beautiful timing on that Torrent, so let's see if he's going to be able to do that. We see Keep of the Light here, as well as Darkseer, trying to help out their friend, the Wisp, just waiting for that tether. That Torrent timing, this time around, not working too well, but again, the follow-up stun by Puppy. There's also an entangled Dendi with the ultimate. Cheshire Cat in trouble. 2 years left from Power Rangers. Shadow will be back in a bit. A Fail Bowl to follow, and Luna in trouble as well. Na'Vi taking control of this game and showing Power Rangers who's boss in Europe. But Power Rangers forced Na'Vi so far as to really show their A game, and I think that is very respectable, and so much respect for Power Rangers right now for pulling this off. Now ZXC in trouble. Down he goes.
Yeah, winning versus Nava full squad, that's not an easy task to do. They played a really entertaining game, and they played it really well.
I agree.
Going up against Navi, which is, when they want, one of the best teams in Europe, I mean, they showed a great game, and credits to them.
Mm-hmm. Again, everybody watching, I do want to thank you guys for tuning in. Obviously, Navi playing, so a bunch of you interested in seeing how this goes. But I have bad news and good news for you watching right now. The first piece of bad news is, if you were looking forward to watching Navi, this is only a best of one. After this, that's it for Navi for the day. That's the bad news, we'll start with that. The good news, though, is that we have a top headliner match following right after, and that is DD Dota versus Mouseboys. You don't want to miss this. It's the three French guys, Fucking Mad, Soksh, as well as Funzy, joined by Silent and former team captain of Team Empire, Goblack, versus, obviously, one of the hottest teams in Europe right now, and that will be the match of the day, and you do not want to miss that. But as you said, my friend, Power Rangers, they throw out a very, very ballsy strat. They succeed with it. They make this match so action-packed, high-paced, and fun to watch. I got nothing but respect for the guys, and I hope to see more of them in the future. But right now, Navi just again showing why they are one of the top teams in Europe. Not the top team anymore, like I would have said perhaps half a year to a year ago, because we have teams like Alliance that are just on fire right now. Even Mouseboys, very powerful at that. But it just goes to show that all teams are getting so much better over time, and it just shows the need for boot camping before the International 3. And I think we have a lot to expect in the future, especially with the metagame changing as it is right now and those new patches coming in. It is a very exciting time to be a Dota fan. Moon on top. Response blinking by Wisp. The torrent combination failed a little bit. Kant is here trying to help out his buddy. Dendy has a DD rune though. The big boat's coming in. 8 more seconds. Wisp walks into the boat. Moon fighting up against Dendy, hoping for those crits, but he's not getting lucky. He needs to find a target for a blink strike, but he can't do it. And it's a double kill on Dendy. Puppy also getting a kill on Shadow Demon in the meantime. Getting kills all over the map.
Yeah, I just want to point out that now Dendy was 1-2 and died to Wisp twice. That's what I will remember. He lost Dyer's mid to Wisp, no doubt.
Puppy looking for that stun. Cheshire Cat's also there. Who does he want to go for? Dendy has arrived one more time. That stun perfectly timed. So the surge is going to wear out just when the stun duration is over. What a well-deserved kill. Oh, the mech is there. Cheshire Cat still going strong. Defensive disruption. ZXC is here. Dendy in trouble. This is such good rotation. And the guy survives. Cheshire Cat, I'm sorry for doubting you, my friend. Puppy on the run out. Eats an Illuminate. Luna still chasing. Kuroki's here. Tier 2 tower on bottom being attacked. This is so exciting. But still, when all is said and done, the map control and the gold graphs and the experience graphs, they're telling the story of Navi being behind at first, but now catching up and winning this game slowly but surely.
Yeah, they are. I don't know what to say. I've enjoyed this game so much, actually. It's a lot of fun. And we have a pause from Havost. 1 minute.
One minute, have to drink vodka.
Yeah. So, one guy was saying they're going after DreamHack Summer, they're going to China. Of course, I should have known that. But doesn't that mean they missed all at the finals, even if they qualify?
I don't know. I mean, you're asking a guy that spends his life observing it as if time has been accelerated a millionfold. It's like, all of a sudden, what? I'm 23? That's ridiculous. What happened? All I did was play Dota, but I had to do it again if I had the chance. So I have no idea, to be honest, how that's going to go. But I should check this out, because I'm casting this event. I should probably be informed about when, what's happening, where. So we'll see. Maybe if Nudie has those stats, when is the LAN final happening for Starladder? Maybe you can bring that up on the new function. That would be pretty nice of you, because that's what these features are kind of for. So we're still playing around with this a little bit, but... but yeah, it's looking pretty good. Again, a reminder, DD Dota versus Mouseboys coming up right after this. It's going to be very exciting. And one more time, thank you guys so much for watching. All 2.6k of you, it's very nice to have you here. My name is Epi, I'm a joint Dota caster. If you haven't heard of me yet, then I hope that you will stick around a little bit more often. You can follow me on Twitter, it's at EpiCommentary. I upload my VODs, so this VOD will also be uploaded on the official joint Dota YouTube. And yeah, we'll also do the DD Dota versus Mouseboys after this. I do some defense season 4 games perhaps, but I might do those in German, as I'm a German person living in Düsseldorf. So we'll see about that. But the game is still paused, so let's stay focused on what's happening here. BKB on Dendy, going into a Hex by the looks of it. Drums, Shadowblade on Kvost, who is now back from his vodka session, point booster, is down on Visage, so obviously Agnon Scepter is such a great item choice. And that Minus Armor also nice. Wisp Ultimate, where is he coming in? On top lane, focusing Funic. ZXC is here as well, and so is Moon. So much damage now coming out, I don't think that Funic stands a chance, unless he's entangling left and right. And he does entangle Wisp, but it's not enough. Down goes Funic up on top, good pickup. Bottom lane! Oh, Wisp! Gets disrupted! ZXC, this guy is money. He's all money, but still, Wisp goes down, it's not enough. Kuroki throwing out those nukes. Charity is in huge trouble. There's that mech charge, but I don't think that he has a chance. His whole assumption, 4 second cooldown, too powerful. And it's a double kill on Kuro.
This Shadow Demon has... Jesus Christ, he's amazing. He's done such good disruptions. Oh no, Jesus is gonna get away from it. Finals will be held in July, okay.
Uh-huh. I love you, Nudie.
Yeah.
And Laowai loves you too.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, we have a BKB on PA. They haven't got Rex yet. We shouldn't count out Power Rangers, actually. They have a Cuddle. We know what a Cuddle can do. And extremely late game, PA will crush. But yeah, how's the gold graph? Yeah, look at that. At least not me. Okay, so 7,500, closing in on 8,000, and XP... Oh, 16,000.
Wisp ultimate overtime. Funic's like, not again. My goodness, please freaking stop it. Any TPs, guys? Want a TP, Kvost?
No. Navi just leaves him alone to suffer.
Poor Funic. He's like, you gotta be kidding me, man. Always on me.
There's not Funic opens team all chat and write this team.
Yeah. Freaking noobs. Especially mid, feeding mid all game long versus Wisp, my god.
He's uninstalled Volta.
Alright, there's a mech down on Keeper of the Light. Let's see what items they have. A Blink Dagger on Puppy now pops up. That's quite an important item. The BKB is down on PA, as you said. X marks the spot, that's what I can hear right now. ZXC fighting. BKB charge used by Dendi into an ultimate, but it doesn't seem to be doing a whole lot. Funic is still dead. Where's this teamfight happening? A huge fight going out. Kvost standing is going against 3 or 4 heroes. It's not enough, they kill him. And the rest of Na'Vi is nowhere to be found. Big vacuum! Cheshire Cat being a boss right now, but Puppy shows up and says, no, you cannot kill my little friend Dendi. I'm the tallest one here, and you cannot do these things to him.
Yeah, too bad.
Oh, Wisp Ultimate! Kuroki! Moon gets stunned! This guy! Tether stunned, Kuroki in trouble, their rotation is coming from Dendi. Is he going to be quick enough? We can see it on the minimap. Puppy's also there, waiting in the wings. Kuroki fights so hard. The Wisp ulti now wears out. Now it's 2v2, and I think Dendi is a little bit stronger. They stun on one hero. Kuroki still helping out by Microlune's units. Shadow Demon in trouble. Luna running away, being attacked from all sides. There's a chicken somewhere else on the, you know, powered by rockets. And Luna gets slowed down, tries to go for a TP, but gets chopped to bits by Nyx Assassin's Claws. And that's a double kill for Puppy. Three heroes down on Power Rangers' side, and Dendi's still looking for anyone. Oh, Fuiso actually looking for his chicken.
Yeah. He's gonna get... No, he's not.
Juke.
That was a nice juke.
Oh, man. Oh, the chicken's like, what's up, man? What do you want? Moon, this is gonna be an important kill, though. If they don't want to lose... The Surge! The Blink Strike! The ultimate by Wisp! No, it's a TP, actually, not an ulti.
Oh, they had to BKB to not die.
Oh, okay. Okay, that's pretty big, but PA actually lives. That's good.
I guess at this time it's kind of worth it.
Puppy gets stunned. Spike Carapace stun is there. The attack from the panel. He's like, where's my master? I want to attack. I can't though. He's too far away. And ZXE, 4, 8, and 8. I can't reiterate enough how well the guys on Power Rangers have been playing. The Wisp, the PA, the Darkseer, Keeper Light, and Shadow Demon. They all played so well.
Yeah. This is insane. Okay, so... what do we have on Kuroki? Okay, here's an axe. I just picked it up. That's nice. Do we have anything on Shadow Demon? No, he's going Mass Bracer build.
Mass Bracer build?
They haven't taken Rex yet. They haven't even threatened tier 3 towers.
Yeah, but you know the thing I'm worried about is the amount of dependence from Power Rangers on PA's crit.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous. They need her to crit like 11 out of...
Yeah, what's the thing Lumi says? RNGG? RNGesus? They need that. They need an immense amount of luck. Maybe go for a Battle Fury just to try to crit down the whole team.
Yeah.
Might be something.
X marks the spot.
Pulse is actually going for it.
It's like a safety belt. He's like, I'm going in, guys. No, I'm not. Smoke used by Cheshire Cat as well as ZXC, so they're roaming around a little bit. They're looking for a kill on Dendy here by the looks of it. But Navi, look at their positioning. This is so good. 4-1 strat, they're all moving in toward Dendy to try and babysit. So this will be a very, very quick... Oh, Dendy. Oh, quick reaction on the BKB. There's that slow. Is there going to be a blink? Karate chop into the back of the head. Dendy just keeps on running. Turns around, he's like, all right, guys, let's fight. Self-disrupt. Darkness is like, peace out, my friend. And ZXC says, please, please, I have wife and kids. And he goes down.
And Darkseid is gonna go down as well.
Darkseid's gonna go down as well. Puppy! Puppy is mana leak though. He's like, I'm chasing you. I'm chasing you one step at a time. But he's still waiting for his blink to be off cooldown. It's gonna be off cooldown in 3 seconds. The surge is still working. Dendy and Puppy.
Oh, there, he's dying.
Oh! That blink from Puppy! He was right on the money! He was right on the money, but now Dendy needs to move in and finish the job. Surge, he's gonna try and juke him here a little bit, I think. No, Cheshire Cat just keeps on running away, and Dendy TP's out. Puppy's still around, and I think the Darkseer is fine. Power Rangers are playing this game pretty nicely. They're turtling, they have the Keeper Light, they can stop the pushes as they're doing right here on bottom. PA getting more powerful by the minute, but she needs more damage, as we said. The BKB is ready, that's a great start, but she needs more items. Top lane in the meantime, Puppy might get overpowered here, both by Wisp and the Darkseer, but the creeps are kind of being traitors right now. Puppy on the run out, and this guy's getting blocked, and they stop the chase as Puppy just blinks away into the river and remains alive.
I'm sorry, I didn't actually think we're gonna see 30 minutes game when at like 20 minutes when Dendy was going massive and they were dying all over, but Power Rangers are they're keeping it strong, man. They should be able to take Roche so soon. Do they have a Vlad's? No, they don't. They need some lifesteal to do it.
The thing is, who is favored by a close quarters Roshan fight? That's a question. Navi, how many BKBs do they have? They only have a BKB on Dendy right now. Kunkka though, he really hasn't, you know, Kovost hasn't been the greatest in terms of landing his boat today, but the Roshan pit definitely helps out in that regard. And Power Rangers, I'm not sure if they want to throw their eggs into that Aegis basket or if they would rather try to challenge Roshan once they notice Na'Vi going for it. So it seems like both teams kind of reluctant to move around the Rosh pit just yet, even though this should be a high priority point on their list at this point. I mean, getting a second life and that extra golden experience would be huge. For the teams right now, especially Power Rangers, they are kind of behind at this point in time. They could very much use a Roshan.
Yeah, they could. The problem is they're so far behind that you really can't go. Look at now, there's a Keeper melting. They're over 10,000 gold behind, over 17,000 XP behind. Yeah. How's the net worths?
Where's Bolti? At the bottom tier too.
What? This is next level creepskipping.
Dendy shows up, and Puppy's here as well. Double TP, that kind of failed, unfortunately enough. Wicked 6-3 on Puppy. This guy's going crazy on the Nyx Assassin. In the meantime, the rest of the team is still going for Roshan, and I don't think they will be able to challenge this. So, Wisp obviously just wanted to push out this bottom lane, but the reaction from Na'Vi was too quick, and they get the Roshan on top of that. Wisp is dead for quite a while. Dendy picks up, Sheepstick done on Dendy. A Basher, the item of choice for PA. Top tower has been
denied. And what is Havos going? Is he going to Linkus? He's not buying his Claymore if he's going Battlefear. I'm hoping he's going Battlefear. I want to see a big crit big hit that melts the whole team.
A Basher also picked up now by the Lone Druid, so let's again have a quick look at the gold graph. 12k, the gold advantage for Na'Vi. If you check out the items, it's just almost overwhelming. I mean, that the fact that Darkseer has a pipe is great for Power Rangers, but if Na'Vi's not moving in, this is going to be a great test for the luck on the PA player. How many crits is he able to throw out? That's a big question. And how much lockdown can they get? Wisp has been spot on with most of his ultimates this game, and I think that that's kind of what they need. They don't want to have a full 5-on-5 fight. They kind of want it spread out in different areas.
No. Wisp is actually going insane. She's going to go... Heaven's Halberd. Okay, so now the sieging begins. And look at this. This bear, man, is going to work.
Absolutely. Well, that's an entangle on Moon. He does have the BKB ready to try and free himself. Puppy blinks in. The blink strike, he dodges it. I don't even think that was intentional, but still, the BKB charge gets used at Na'Vi back out. They want to make sure that PA has the least time possible on the magic immunity. and Power Rangers are still turtling it up. In the meantime, the birds, the familiars from Kuroki, pushing out the top lane, and Navi is slow sieging that mid tier 3.
Yeah, there's only a question of time when they manage to break the tier 3. I'm actually loving how Power Rangers are split it though. Look, they're like 2-3 meter radius where they are standing. And we have soon the Aghanims on Doxy, that might change something.
Absolutely, that's going to be another core item on him. He needs about 1k gold. If they win a team fight, then that would definitely be it. And Fnatic takes a bunch of damage right now. Dendi getting X-marked, going in for a little scream and some slow puppy to follow up. The stun misses completely though.
This goes to tower enough, but the bear dies. Now, fight.
900 crit on Moon right now. That hurts quite a bit. And Dendi has the hex ready. Moon, don't overextend. He has a BKB, not ready just yet, gets focused, he doesn't even have a second life, he's going in quite aggressively. Dendi goes for the ultimate. Moon has a blink strike away defensively. Now this might not be the fight that Power Rangers were looking for, as ZXC goes down in the back on the play. Dendi blinks up there as well. It's a double kill, a monster kill on Puppy. Two heroes drop. Havost also dead on Navi's side. And Moon is still chasing. Wisp is also here, the ultimate is ready. But Navi need to stick together at this point. DD rune picked up by Queen of Pain in the meantime. Do Power Rangers want to fight this? I mean, they repelled the push. They shouldn't chase all this far.
Well, they should just farm on the PA. PA didn't die, she got a kill. It's all good. How is Kunkka doing? Oh, he's not getting anything. Okay, he's going Lincolns. He hasn't bought anything. He has to go Lincolns. But why would he go? Oh, Lincolns for Blink, maybe. I don't know.
Oh, man. Puppy. He does find Moon on top. The Fallout Birds, the Aghanims. It's three birds. They do so much damage. Kuroki gets the kill with the Soul Catcher. Luna gets slowed down looking for that TP, but the burst damage is just too much. Kuroki doesn't even bother trying to stun him out of that channel because they knew that the damage would just be too much. Yule Scepter picked up by Puppy as well, top tier 2, about to drop. And that's what happens if, as a team as far behind as Power Rangers is right now, if you leave your base too, you know, they were too far out.
Yeah. So, sarcasmadan, Epi. Yeah. Don't know what that means.
Maybe the Russians in chat can let us know. Blink in by Puppy, get the stun out on ZXC. Shadowbeam gets his mana burn as well, but so there's plenty of left where that came from. Top tier 300 siege, that one's gonna drop right now as well. PA still dead, no buyback available. And that is probably gonna be the top racks if Funic were to focus the buildings with his bear. Puppy goes in again, Dendi follow up. Ultimate not ready yet. Good vacuum by the Darkseid, but he's not able to get the wall out. He's even out of mana, completely out of it. Puppy goes in, Visk, EO now getting focused as well. Funic going in with the bear. Cheshire Cat can't do anything but stand and watch. ZXC in the midst of it. And they have to watch their Wisp getting mowed down. Luna also under tank right now. She is really not as tanky as she would like to be. Funic still chasing. The bear being committed. The surge away. And Kibberlite still alive. Moon now respawn. There's that stun on Spirit Bear. Kuroki's birds going quite crazy. And ultimate used on the Spirit Bear as well. Funic doesn't have a resummon for another 50 seconds. But during this time, the top barracks have gone down. Funic looking for that TP. Disruption will be there. Wisp is still dead. Funic will be in trouble right now. The boat's coming in, hits on ZXC. Dendi's up there now too. Funic still getting chased. The wall gets dropped by Cheshire Cat. Surge himself gets taken out of the fight by Nyx Assassin's Yule Scepter. And Shadow Demon and Wisp are dead. Moon still there, throwing out his slow. Dendi getting focused. Just like Darkseer, they're only less effective. And it's three heroes dead from Power Rangers, and Navi kind of outplaying Power Rangers in this engagement here right now. BKB used by Moon. Gets a kill on Dendi. That was quite the crit. And continuing the chase. Mana leak on Havos, he needs to stop. Kuroki standing his ground. Desolator is ready, so is the Aghanim Scepter. Puppy goes in with the stun. The birds will follow up and chain it out. And Moon is in trouble, he's definitely gonna drop. And that's it, that's game. Navi, take this one.
Yeah, nothing but respect for Power Rangers. This is one of the most entertaining games I've seen in a while. Ballsy strat, ballsy move, ballsy place. I hope they stay together and get a lot of results done in time. They look very promising. Dire's middle
barracks are under attack. The boat just for good measure, and Navi more interested in regaining their honor of what just happened in the early game versus Power Rangers, and there's nothing they can do. The middle barracks are also down. Dendi gonna join the party here, as by the looks of it. His ultimate is up again. There's the hex, there's a scream, there's a blink out. And Navi doing what Navi does best, just wrecking havoc all over the place.
So yeah, Doxy finally gets his Aga, but it's, sorry mate, it's 5 minutes too late. And he also got his Battle Fury, he's gonna splash some stuff down.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Then he has... Oh, they have the Ghost Scepters. They don't want to die to PA anymore.
Who is pulled into an odd position. Moon is there with him. Poppy might get caught. Spike Carapace gets used. Moon going up onto Danny, but he has a Ghost Scepter complete. It just blinks away like nobody's business. The Torrent is pretty good. Moon to follow up and gets the kill. On Queen of Pain, no Funic going crazy with the Entangles. There's Darkseer. Oh, with that Aghanim Scepter wall, all these illusions going crazy, but Puppy Spike Carapace is doing some good work right there. Moon gets taken up by the Yule Scepter. It's two heroes dead on Power Ranger's side, and just Dendi on Na'Vi's squad. The Torrent hits on him. Chavos goes in for another hit. Self-disrupt by ZXE. Chavos needs to back out. Or, no, he doesn't care. He's just like, I'm low, but I don't care. I'm just going to keep on fighting. Funic's also there, just right-clicking with his main hero. And ZXE gets killed by the Klee from Kunkka. That was beautiful.
Yeah, Sarcasm Milan apparently means stop killing around. Besides, just bought a Desolator. That's awesome. Desolator Massage. New meta. And yeah, it's not much to say now. They're just kidding around.
Yeah, that Desolator definitely hurting quite a bit. I mean, it synergizes kind of well, obviously, with the medallion. He just wants to kid around, have some fun with the game, and I mean, I was just glad that we were able to kind of join them and having fun here. Kunkka drops, Wisp ulti gets used, Puppy immediately turns around, Funic is here too.
And he's dead.
I don't know, 4 seconds is not that long of a time. The stuns are going in, the mana burn is there, and dead he is.
Let's see.
They still want to keep on fighting. Yule Scepter takes out Moon. He blink strikes, gets vacuumed, or Funic gets vacuumed, and is bare. And Power Rangers, they still want to fight.
Yeah, Yule, yeah. Croaker, go in and hit him, man.
You got a Desolator, man. You can just wreck his face
exactly.
Any day.
No, the base is dying. I don't want this game to end. This is heavily entertaining.
Yeah.
Where's PA there? Get a crit, man.
Again, to all you guys tuning in right now, this was obviously Na'Vi versus Power Rangers, a team that, on paper, I think 89% were betting that Na'Vi would take this game, and the viewers were right as well. But after this, we have DD Dota versus Mousesports coming up right after as Dendi screams down two supports. The first one to drop, the second one is Shadow Demon now going down. Kuroki getting attacked by Moon, that's a pretty fast cheap, gets stunned up by Puppy as well. The mana burns here, the burst damage coming in. BKB to no avail, down goes PA, dominating Spear on Funic. That will be the Ancient dropping very shortly. Cheshire Cat also in trouble, and Wisp will be the sole survivor unless this bear tanks up the fountain and Na'Vi dives. DG gets called by Moon. They obviously had some fun, so just to finish that train of thought, DD Dota versus Mousesports coming up just right after this game. And that's the match of the night, so you don't want to miss that. You need to stick around. It is 5 minutes to 6. So the game is scheduled to start at 6, so we're going to start on time. Stick around, and let's enjoy some more great Dota. Mousesports versus DD. That will be it. The GG gets called. It was very, very fun. Thanks a lot to Power Rangers for making this game so entertaining. They put up a great fight against Na'Vi, but Na'Vi in the end, they win it. They take it out, and it looks like the panda is actually drooling, in case anybody saw that there, but now we can only see his butt. This is the endgame screen, my dear friends. I take a screenshot because I will just switch over to this overlay. I want to thank you guys for tuning in. It's been a great pleasure to have you. Please stick around. DD versus Mousesports is coming out in just a few moments' time. Until then, guys,